grew up in the country. Almonds, grapes at one time, almonds all around now.
Martha Lorenz lives in the shade of almond trees in the house where she grew up.
It was nice. Back then, well, it was a lot smaller town.
This area outside Ceres doesn't get city water. Her family relied on a well.
I didn't think anything about it as a kid, you know, you just go to the sink and get your glass of water.
2 years ago, she found out that the water she was drinking was contaminated with nitrate.
Would not have known if it wasn't tested.
The chemical is odorless and colorless, but it can be dangerous. In infants, it can cause blue baby syndrome or low oxygen in the blood, which can be fatal. It can also cause cancer if water levels are higher than 10 milligrams per liter.
As a kid, I drank out of the hose all the time.
Gary Schaffner also lives near Orchards. He installed a reverse osmosis system to try and eliminate the nitrate. It didn't work.
They dump fertilizer right out there in front of the house on that side, and then they take it and they spread it out every year.
Nitrate can come about from a number of sources: urban wastewater applied on the land, septic tanks, farm manure, or fertilizer on golf courses or crops.
Nitrate is not sticking to the soil. In fact, it doesn't want to be anywhere close to any soil particles, so it sits right in the middle of that water stream.
UC Davis nitrate expert Thomas Harder says climate change and extreme weather can make contamination worse. The key is balance and allowing crops to take up more nitrogen so there aren't any leftover nutrients in the soil at summer's end.
Then winter can come and all that rain can come and we can do all that managed aquifer recharge on top of it and not have to worry about large residual amounts of nitrate that are in the soil.
Nitrate contamination is often thought of as a rural problem, but here in California, it's urban as well. This map shows the groundwater with nitrate contamination in just San Joaquin and Stanislaus counties. Everything in red is unsafe to drink. Zoom out farther, and wells in Yolo, Sacramento, Placer, and El Dorado counties are affected. But there is some help.
Our program is totally free. They get a free well test, they get the results free.
The Valley Water Collaborative is a partnership between the ag industry, local government, and water agencies. They use state grants to help people get safe water.
When we determine they're above the drinking water standard, they get free bottled water. I dare say forever.
It takes us about 8 days to go through a bottle.
That's how Gary Schaffner gets his water.
Would you like to have a taste?
Martha Lorenz is part of a pilot program using a system that gets drinking water from humidity in the air.
It's piped into the house. I have a spigot at the kitchen sink. Just turn the tap on, the water comes out.
There we go.
They also hooked up to the refrigerator.
Creative and temporary fixes for a problem still being tackled across the state.
It's all well water. That's what we rely on for drinking water. So yeah, we've got to protect that resource for sure and also ensure that people that are here have access to safe drinking water.
In Ceres, Brittany Hope, KCRA3 investigates.
Right now, the Valley Water Collaborative only services those portions of Stanislaus County, but they are looking to expand and other locations will be covered by the end of 2024. They're funded by state grants and the testing and bottled water are free for residents they serve. If you want to find out if you live near a nitrate impacted water well, our team created an interactive map. You can enter your address and it will show you any nearby wells. This is available right now on the KCRA 3 News app and KCRA.com. You'll find it under the 3 Investigates tab on that menu. And do you have a tip for KCRA 3 Investigates? We want to hear from you. Call 3 at 916-325-3344 or you can send an email to KCRA3Investigates@KCRA.com. We'll look into your tip, but make sure to leave your contact information so we can get back to you.